Top two transfer. Top two transfer. Again, we'll be going 10 laps. Todd Morrow in the T1. And Joey Coulter in the 2. We'll set the pace and bring him to green here. At the start point off turn number 4, green flag waves, and here we go. We are underway. And Joey Coulter going to roll the top shelf and go to the race lead. Todd Morrow going to be second. Gary McPherson third. But look at beneath him for the third spot is Jamie Oliver in her 38. They're side by side for third down into turn 1. Side by side for the lead as well. Coulter and Morrow. Coulter working off the high side. Keeps Morrow behind him. Those two in the transfer spots at this point with Jamie Oliver in third. Gary McPherson and Colby Kilgore fourth and fifth. Yes, Coulter making a high side work through turns 1 and 2, but he dives to the bottom in a 3 and 4. Coulter showing the way in the deuce with Morrow still second. Oliver third, McPherson fourth, Kilgore in fifth. Eric Granger rides in sixth in the G9. But Joey Coulter continues to set the pace out in front of this one for the time being. Feature winner at Crossville Speedway last night. He and Todd Morrow in that T1 right now in the transfer spots. And then it's several car lengths back to the 38 of Jamie Oliver, who is third. Gary McPherson fourth. And a Colby Kilgore, who rides in fifth. As we're halfway home in this one, we'll put lap number 6 up this time by 6 down, 4 to go for race leader Joey Coulter. Todd Morrow still second, Jamie Oliver third. Gary McPherson and Colby Kilgore still going at it for fourth and fifth. He has Coulter right back to the bottom end, 3 and 4, down the front straightaway. Still working that high side middle through turns 1 and 2. He's found something up there that his Longhorn chassis likes. Yeah, he may encounter some slower traffic before we get done as the 2 to go signaled out on this one. 2 to go in the first of 2 Shapers Oil Southern National Bonus Series B main events. Coulter about to bring that machine off turn number 4 to the white flag. 1 lap to go here in a B main number 1. Yet only the top 2 got a transfer on. As they race down the back straightaway for the final time into turn 3 and off of turn number 4, it'll be Concord, North Carolina's Joey Coulter, the winner of B main number 1. Todd Morrow in the T1 will come home in second. Jamie Oliver will be third, Gary McPherson fourth, and Colby Kilgore will complete the top 5. And the caution lights are out, and we're getting set to come to green here in the final B main of the night. Crate Lake model feature, you need to be in staging as they get ready to bring them to green. It's out, and we are underway. Good-looking start down into turn number 1. Who's going to come off there in 2 with the lead? Ross Bales is going to have it. Forrest Trent going to go to second. Yes, Austin Smith looking beneath David Payne. They're side-by-side for third. Off of turn 4, David Payne goes around. Caution lights out. We get set to come to the green flag. Ross Bales had got the early advantage there prior to that caution coming out. Let's see what happens this time as they get ready to pull the trigger on them here off turn number 4. Green flag's going to wave, I believe. Trent out of shape. Bales jumps to the early race lead. Trent in second. Ronnie Johnson trying to work around the outside of Johnny Clower for third. He's got that done down into turn number 1. Johnson going to try to make that high side work here with Bales out in front. Trent in second, and the Chattanooga Flash is coming on the high side. Working off turn number 4. Closing in on Trent now down into turn number 1. RJ trying to make the top shelf work here at North Georgia Speedway in his second B main. He's right on Trent's back bumper. He'll look to the outside as they enter turns three and four. Ross Bell's gone with it out in front. But the battle's for second right now between the 101 of Forrest Trent and the 85 of Ronnie Johnson. And Johnny Glower closing right in there in the mix as well. Bales setting sail out in front, continues to lead the way. Johnson almost had a run to the outside of Trent, but Trent closed the door on him coming off turn number two there. RJ looked to the outside of the Talbot, Tennessee native. Still not able to make a go of it as the halfway signal has been shown in this one. Halfway to the house in the second and final Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus Series B main of the night. Ross Bell showing a way out in front. Trent and Johnson battling for the second position. A little contact there. Trent slides up the racetrack. Here comes Ronnie Johnson. He'll look beneath him. They'll go side by side for the bridesmaid spot. The final transfer position off of turn number four. Johnson maybe by a few inches of the nose that time by. As Forrest Trent now battles to the outside of Johnson. He'll reclaim that second position off turn two down the back straightaway. All this going on behind race leader Ross Bales as a two-lap to go signal has been shown, and RJ not done yet in that battle for second. Bales with this one well in hand. Johnson right there all over Trent as they work off turn number four. White flag in the air, one lap to settle it. Johnson to the outside of Trent for the second position down into turn number one. And Trent slides up. They make a bit of contact. That causes RJ to slide up. Off of turn number four, Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bell is going to get the win. Second, we'll go to Forrest Trent. Third will be Ronnie Johnson. Fourth, going to be Johnny Glower. And fifth, Jaden Frame.